equilibrium is, once equilibrium is affect, once equilibrium is achieved, what are the factors that affect? That was given by Chatelier, and he has given a principle called Lee Chatelier principle. So we'll take one example, like nitrogen and hydrogen react and it makes what? Ammonia. So once the equilibrium is achieved, if we change the any factor like concentration, temperature, pressure, catalyst, or inert gases, if any one of the factor is affected, then equilibrium try to oppose these changes. Equilibrium just oppose the change. What we make the change, and it try to come into the original state or maintain their state. So that was explained by Chatelier. We call it the Chatelier principle. Chatelier principle. What this principle says, according to this principle, change in any state or any factor that determine the equilibrium conditions of a system will cause the system to change. Will cause the system to change. In such a manner so as to reduce the effect of that change. Means this law says that whenever we make any change out of these changes to equilibrium will try to oppose that change. How? Because in this, if you see, read the statement, it calls system to change in such a manner so as to reduce the effect of that change. Suppose if we take the effect of concentration, first we will study effect of concentration. Number one, nitrogen hydrogen react to form ammonia and it is at equilibrium. Now suppose you change the concentration. Change in concentration, what happens? Suppose if you increase the concentration of product, increase the concentration of product, what will product, suppose first we start from this side, what will happen? Equilibrium will disturb. Why? Because already it is at equilibrium and you are increasing the concentration of product this side. So what will happen to the equilibrium? Equilibrium try to minimize the effect. Equilibrium try to oppose that effect. So how it can oppose the effect? By consuming the excess amount you have added. How it can consume? By shifting the equilibrium in the backward direction. You can say the equilibrium will shift in the backward direction, or more we can say reactant are formed. So direction you got, you increase the concentration of product. Suppose if I write, if increase the concentration of reactant, then what will happen? What you will write? You increase the concentration this side. Equilibrium will try to oppose this increase. If you increase this side, then what will happen? Equilibrium will disturb. So how it will again come into the normal position? By consuming more of the reactant or excess reactant. That means equilibrium will shift in the forward direction. So you will write here what? Equilibrium will move into the forward direction. So one thing is clear. If you increase concentration of reactant at equilibrium, it will go in the forward direction. If you increase product, it will come back into the which side? Reactant side. Now if I reverse the condition, suppose if I tell you the condition C, if concentration of reactant decrease, can anybody tell what will happen? Its concentration is decreased. Or if I say nitrogen or hydrogen is removed, if it is written like this, then what will happen? Because equilibrium will also get disturbed by adding or by removing both the side, it will get disturbed. So if it is removed from this side, then what will happen? Equilibrium disturbed. So how it will come back to normal, or how it will oppose the change? Yes, by removing, equilibrium will come backward direction again, so that more of the N2 and H2 is formed because you have removed it. So what you will write? Equilibrium will come in which side? Backward direction, so that the effect can be minimized. Ultimately, whatever change you make, effect can be minimized. That is the purpose of this. Whatever the effect, that should be minimize. Right? Now, if I say you both conditions, if products are removed, or concentration of product is removed, if you remove the ammonia, ammonia is removed at equilibrium. Yes, what will happen? You can tell very easily now. Suppose this is removed to balance the equilibrium, equilibrium will come into the forward direction. So you will write what? Equilibrium will shift in the forward direction so that whatever the change you have done, the effect of that change can be minimized. Because you have removed, once you remove, equilibrium is disturbed, try to maintain it, so more of the N2 and H2 react and the product, more product is formed. So these four conditions you must remember, that is the effect of concentration. I'll summarize it again. First, increasing concentration of reactant, product go forward direction so that reactant can be consumed. Increase in concentration of product this side, equilibrium go backward so that more of the product can be consumed and more of the reactant is formed. Removal. Removal of reactant backward, removal of product forward. This is the effect of what? Concentration. I think it is clear for everyone, effect of concentration. These 4 points, you must go through it. Then we will take the second effect. Effect of temperature. How temperature affects the reaction. You know, there are two types of reaction. One is called endothermic, another is exothermic. Here, heat is absorbed, and here, heat is released. Right? Endo and exo you studied in the previous standard also. Endo means comes in, exo means goes out. Now, suppose a reaction is endothermic in nature. Endothermic reaction, what happens? Because endothermic reactions always try to absorb heat. Endothermic reactions always try to absorb heat. If I take example where heat is absorbed and how equilibrium will affect. Suppose if I take calcium carbonate is heated, CaCO3, on heating gives CaO plus CO2. This is solid and gas. This reaction is endothermic in nature. So if it is endothermic and you increase the temperature, what will happen? Because this reaction is endothermic, high temperature favor the reaction. So reaction will go in the forward direction. Why? because you are doing favorable work for it. Whatever temperature you are increasing at equilibrium, it helps us to form more product. You can see more products are formed. And suppose you decrease the temperature at equilibrium. What we are doing, this all we are doing at equilibrium, remember. ये सारे चेंजेस इक्विलिब्रियम पे ही कर रहे हैं, अज्यूमिंग दैट. तो अब आप ऑपोजिट काम कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज द रिएक्शन नेचर इज व्हाट एंडोथर्मिक, दे ट्राई टू हीट एब्जॉर्ब हीट एंड यू आर डिक्रीजिंग द टेम्परेचर, मींस व्हाट, इक्विलिब्रियम विल गो बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन, लेस प्रोडक्ट, बिकॉज आप क्या कर दिए, आपने अपोजिट काम कर दिया, एंडोथर्मिक और टेम्परेचर आपने कम कर दिया. सेम वे इफ आई से द रिएक्शन इज एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर, व्हाट विल हैपन? एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन मींस रिएक्शन इन विच हीट इज रिलीज. इफ आई टेक N2 plus H2 gives NH3. Haber's process. Right? And suppose it is released already, it is negative. Now, at this time, if you increase the temperature for equilibrium, at equilibrium, so what you are doing, you are doing opposite work. Reaction already it is liberating, it is evolved, it don't need heat, and you are increasing the temperature. That means equilibrium will shift opposite to that is in backward direction. Less product will be formed. Why? Because you are doing unfavorable things to it. It's an exothermic and you are still increasing the temperature. That means to minimize that effect, ammonia will decompose and more nitrogen and hydrogen is formed. Because this side it is exothermic, then this side will be an endothermic. So whatever the heat you are increasing, that is absorbed and the reaction become again on equilibrium. And suppose at this temperature, you decrease the temperature. You decrease the temperature because it is, again if I say, it is an exothermic and you are doing favorable thing for it because heat is already released. So equilibrium will shift in the forward direction. More of the product is formed. More product. That you have to understand. Clear? So, if I reverse these things, if I ask you in a different way, understand everyone and ask the questions if you don't understand, what is the effect of temperature we are studying? There are two types of reaction, endothermic and exothermic. Endothermic is a reaction which absorbs heat. Heat is absorbed, and exothermic where heat is released. Suppose the reaction is already endothermic, and if I ask you, it is at equilibrium, how will you get more product? How will you get more product for a endothermic reaction? You will say by increasing the temperature, because reaction nature is what? Endothermic. Endothermic, increasing temperature, reaction goes forward. Forward means more product. Clear? If I ask you for a exothermic reaction, how will you get more product? You will say decreasing the temperature, because this will cause the forward direction. So that you have to understand what is the nature of reaction and how the equilibrium will shift and in what directions it will shift. Clear? Because equilibrium try to oppose that effect. This is called effect of temperature. Now understand the effect of pressure. How pressure change the equilibrium, or if we change the pressure at equilibrium, how it is affected and how equilibrium is affected, right? So obvious, we take example of Haber's process. Nitrogen gas react with hydrogen gas to form ammonia gas. Right? Now, suppose you change the pressure, you increase the pressure or you decrease the pressure of reactant or product, then equilibrium try to oppose that effect. So a pressure change obtained by changing the volume can affect the yield of product in case of gaseous reaction, where the total number of moles of gaseous reactant and total number of moles of gaseous product are different. Suppose if you see this reaction here, the total number of gaseous reactant are how many? 4, 3 plus 1. And here total number of moles of product is what? 2. So this reaction goes in the lesser volume or lesser moles, because here volume is decreasing. You can say volume is decreasing. Why? Because 4 volume of gaseous reactant gives only 2 volumes of this. Or in other words, the reaction is from higher moles to lower moles. You can write. Volume is decreasing. Why we are writing? Because here the gaseous moles of the reactant is 4 and the product moles is only 2. So volume is obvious decreasing. This type of reaction, if pressure is increased, the equation or the equilibrium will go in the forward direction. Can you tell why? Why by increasing the pressure, equilibrium will go in the forward direction? Because from 4 volume, we are getting only 2 volume. So if you increase the pressure, you can get more product. And second conditions, if pressure is decreased, by decreasing the pressure, the equilibrium will shift in the backward direction, opposite. The second condition for this is, if the volume is increasing, for a reaction, if the volume is increasing, then what will happen? Suppose if if I take the example C cock, which is in a solid state, react with CO2 and it makes 2CO, 2CO gaseous moles. So here the moles of reactant is 1 and moles of gaseous moles of this is 2. So here volume is increasing from 1 to 2 because this is solid, leave it. So gaseous moles are increasing, then what will happen? You can say the reaction is already proceeding in the higher volume. Lesser volume are giving higher volume because one volume of this giving two volume. So by decreasing the pressure, you can get more product. Equilibrium will go in the forward direction. Can you say why? Because reaction already giving 1 to 2 moles, from lesser volume we are getting higher volume, so we cannot increase the pressure. Or if I say opposite, by increasing the pressure we will get less product, or reaction will go in the backward direction. So what you have to remember, two type of reaction in the case of pressure, where volume is increasing and volume is decreasing, higher to lower mole. And here you can say from lower moles to higher moles, gaseous moles in case of this. So here you have to understand, if the reaction is proceeding from higher to lower moles, then how you will get more product? By increasing the pressure. Because forward direction kab jayega? Jab aap pressure ko kya karenge? Increase karenge. Aur agar reaction already low se higher de raha hai, to aapko pressure kam karna hai. Matlab aap ek cheez learn kar lena ki forward jane ki kya method hai. So opposite automatic learn ho jaye, right? This is called effect of pressure. Two type of effect you have to study. Then it comes next fourth effect, effect of catalyst. You know what is the role of catalyst? It helps in speeding the reaction. So you can write, it does not affect the equilibrium. It helps in achieving the equilibrium. Means once the equilibrium is achieved, there is no role of catalyst. Catalyst just help in achieving the equilibrium. It do not affect the equilibrium. Yes, it help in achieving the equilibrium because it increases both the reaction the same way, forward and backward. So once we use catalyst at equilibrium, what happens? It not only speed up the forward, it also speed up the backward, and that's why the we can say it do not affect, overall effectivity is not there for catalyst. So you remember, for this catalyst do not affect the equilibrium. And the last factor is inert gases. Inert gases, by adding inert gas, if the volume is kept constant and inert gas is added, like argon, neon, helium, by adding this, that they do not affect the equilibrium, or they does not take part in the reaction because they are inert. So from this also, equilibrium remains unaffected. There is no effect of inert gases at equilibrium, because addition of an inert gas at constant volume does not change the partial pressure. By adding this, there is no change in pressure or the molar concentration of the substance. So reaction quotient change only if added gas is reactant or product involved in the reaction. So these five main points you have to study in inert gases: how inert gases, or temperature, pressure, catalyst, and inert gases concentration affect the equilibrium.